Welcome to Insight, produced in partnership with WIPB-TV and Indiana Public Radio at Ball State University. Today we are chatting with Kellie Kelley, Executive Director of Habitat for Humanity of Madison County, Indiana. Kellie has generously agreed to share some of her experience with us. Thank you, Kellie, for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So Habitat for Humanity has a national program. It is very well known. We'll talk about the national program in a second. But here in Madison County, these programs take a particular character. Talk about the need for a program like Habitat for Humanity, and then let's talk about the unique features of the program here in these counties.
Sure. Well, Habitat for Humanity often comes with several myths, and many believe that Habitat's sole mission is to find families in need and to actually donate a home to them or to give them a home. What I'm learning in the past year as being the leader of Madison County's affiliate is that it's the farthest thing from that. There's a true cooperative with families who are looking for an opportunity for home ownership. And it is one that requires a lot of collaborative effort, learning what it means to be a homeowner, learning to budget, learning finances, learning what it means to leverage your wealth through owning your own home. And so there are a lot of myths and things to be corrected when we talk about Habitat. And as the newest executive director of Madison County, I'm learning that as well.
So it's so interesting because what Habitat is really about in this environment in particular is the transformative experience through a partnership. And it is a transfer of knowledge, a development of new habits, design. There are design elements here, not only design of a home, but also of your own life and how your finances work. There's so much to this. How do you first select the families that you are partnering with?
We have an open application process, and smaller affiliates like Madison County usually do that one time a year. During that process, we take applications for anyone who is interested in learning more about the program, but has already stated and observed in themselves a need for improved housing. That could be anything from being outpaced by their income. Perhaps their rent has gone up and they can't afford their home any longer. They've outgrown the space. It's not safe. So in that application process, they state their housing need. They also will give us a snapshot of their financial situation. One of the things that we try to do is we serve low to moderate income families that earn approximately 30 to 60% of the average median income from the area. And so that, in addition to being prepared to take on a mortgage, is also assessed in that application. And then the third criteria involves their willingness to partner. And so when we talk about sweat equity, which we all have heard with the Association of Habitat, we have a minimum of 250 hours of sweat equity that's required from every adult that will be living in the home. And it's those three general criteria that we use in our application process.
And what's really interesting is there's the first the decision to apply, then there's the decision in the application to share really sensitive truths about oneself, and then to grapple with how to adjust your life to allow for home ownership at this scale. So it is really a transformative experience.
It absolutely is. And I do believe, and I understand this to be true about our community, in that probably a very small portion, I would say the less than 10% who would qualify for a Habitat home even begin the application process because of that very reason you've mentioned. We do ask sensitive questions about types of income that are coming into the home. We ask, you know, has there been a credit concern in the past? Are there outstanding bills that have been kind of haunting you to this point? You know, what has kept the family from gaining a traditional loan? Which is typically the families that we serve. Perhaps there's been steady income. there's been a true effort to make a stable household for a family, but they've just not been able to get over that hump and earn enough or get past some of the credit issues that would allow them to get a traditional home loan.
And your people have to balance compassion and an emotional intelligence with a real business savvy, because at the end of the day, you want to leave a family able to continue to that climb into self-sufficiency, and not overwhelmed by the prospect of home ownership, which creates all sorts of other problems. Mm-hmm. So the actual skills that you have to bring in, that balance of compassion on the one hand, really strong compassion, but you cannot give an inch on the business savvy that's required.
No, and one of the things I learned early on in my training through our state support office was, you know, it's one thing to see a family in need, and it's another thing to see a willing family, but it's another thing to set a family on course for success. This is not emergency housing. This is not temporary. This is a lifelong transformational opportunity, and if we set a family on path for that that's not ready or that is not truly understanding what they're taking on, then we've done them a disservice.
The other aspect here is that you're planting someone within a community, so you've got this long-term community development aspect. If I am a donor or I am a foundation that you're approaching, why should I invest in Habitat compared to another organization that also provides relief for people in need?
So there are a lot of different programs that could offer a path to home ownership or at least affordable housing for a family. What is unique about Habitat is that we do have, I guess what I would call social service or wraparound offerings, where once we partner with a family, we really partner with them for the length of that mortgage. And so that would include, if there are times, which there are often life events, these individuals have not ever experienced home ownership. And when we get involved, we are able to connect them with resources in the community. If there's particularly bad winter like there is this season, you know, and utility bills are a little bit off the chart, then they may find themselves in a pinch. And so we are mindful of that. One of the things that I don't think most realize is that Habitat is actually the funder and the loan originator as well as the servicer for a period of time. And so what's unique to that is that, again, we get to know our partner families and we do ride that journey with them, and we help connect them to services as they need them. Now, we don't have a full social service department in many of the small affiliates, but we are very well connected with our local United Ways. We have a lot of partners in the community that we work together with.
In many respects, this is an extension of the American model of home ownership as a key to community building and community strength. This whole idea of this long-term commitment from the organization as the mortgage holder and as the sponsor of this program is really different. If you take a look at the different needs, there's sometimes immediate and crisis needs, which are generally supplied by other people. Then you come in and you're catching a family when they're ready for stability but might not have the means. Yes. You bridge that gap of means and you help them going forward until they are really stabilized, then you might hand over the mortgage to another processor, and then you help another family.
Absolutely. And the beautiful thing about Habitat is it's cyclical or it's recyclable in the sense that when we do take on a mortgage and that family begins making payments, that goes right back into the construction till first. I mean, that's our first and foremost mission, is to build homes or rehab or repair homes and put individuals in decent housing.
So talk about housing as a way to address depression, mental health issues, physical health issues, social cohesion.
You know, at the very basic level or foundational level of our stability is dependable housing. It is a safe place to call home. It is ground zero for families to grow, converse, feel comforted, for students to complete homework, for friends and socialization. All of these things are represented by a stable home. And so, you know, once that basic need is taken care of, then families begin to kind of raise their head up, you know, look for other opportunities. They feel, you know, capable, relaxed. That's something they don't have to worry about. And so allowing that opportunity for families who've never had that is a tremendous reward.
So you have shelter, pride, respect, community connection, the development of neighborhoods, right, social cohesion, all of those different elements, the reduction in stress levels, all of those different elements lead to a healthier individual and a healthier society.
Absolutely. You know, we've had families tell us, look, this is the first time I've had a quiet night's sleep. I don't hear the neighbors yelling. I don't hear gunshots in the distance. I feel comfortable that my family is safe and sound. We have four solid walls. I'm not worried about mold. I mean, there are things that seem very elemental maybe to some of us, but they are pretty profound to others.
You accept people from where they come. You treat them with respect. You then together develop a plan that will transform their lives. It's a voluntary interaction. There's information that is exchanged. You then embark on a journey with certain results, with a certain commitment to those results, and then you leave people more capable, healthier, more satisfied, and more set up for the future.
I couldn't have said it better, but that's exactly, I mean.
See, I read your literature.
Yeah, that's right. Well, I'm very fortunate to be involved in an organization such as Habitat. It's been transforming for myself, quite frankly, and for the volunteers that are involved. I mean, it's very a mutual giving. Those who come to the job site and they contribute to the builds of these families' homes, they leave at the end of the day feeling just as gratified as that homeowner will when they have their first night's sleep in that home. And so I'm very proud and honored to be part of that and connecting volunteers who want to give back and being part of something bigger than themselves. It's a blessing to be part of that.
Wonderful story, a wonderful blessing, Kellie Kelley. Thank you so much for sharing the work of Habitat for Humanity of Madison County. And thank you so much for your insights.
Thank you.